Hello, I'm Malin, and I'm back to do another painting. So I do the Bob Ross kind of style that was developed also by Bill Alexander, the Wet on Wet. And today I'm going to kind of do some mountains because I've been working on them quite a bit, and I've learnt how to do them a lot better because I was making a lot of mistakes with my mountains. And I kind of realised what I was doing wrong. So I'm just putting the liquid kind of white on. I just have this bottle, I find it just easier to put it on like that. And probably should have my right. My easel isn't that strong because I just got a kind of cheap one because I wasn't sure if I was going to continue painting or not. I kind of have just continued painting. But we make do with whatever we have. So the kind of reasoning behind putting this on first is that you mix the colours that you put on top of it whilst you're painting. And this saves kind of time because you don't have to do it all on your palette. I'm going to put the colours on all at once now so then I don't have to kind of come back. I'm using Talo Blue. That's a really nice sky blue colour and it's also great for mountains. Van Dyke Brown, great for mountains, trees, leaves, trees, yeah, thanks. Sap Green, that's a really nice green. I love the colour of Sap Green. I've also got alizarin crimson, another colour for mountains. It's also great if you want to do sunsets as well. I'll probably come back and get some more of these. I kind of just eyeball it at the start, and well, if I wasn't recording I'd just kind of go along as I go, but then that takes quite a bit of time. Look at that! It's freaking massive. You know? Kind of makes me like a bit insecure. Anyway. So I'll start with a blue sky. I'll just quickly pop it in. And some water down here, just kind of wipe it off. Paint that I've had. You see how easy it is just to get that done straight away? Like, with the white on there already, you kind of can just meld it together really easily. So I'm just going to quickly wipe this and then blend the sky a bit better. Usually I do clouds, but today I'm just going to leave it so then I have more time to kind of show you the mountains. Mountains, yes. Use that brown, blue, crimson, and some of the white. Let's see how that turns out. I kind of want it. So when you're kind of doing a painting, you've got to have the things that are in the background kind of a lighter color than the ones that are at the front, because there's more light towards the back because that's where the sun's from. And then as you come closer, it has more detail. And it also is darker in colour. Alright, that's an alright colour. Maybe a bit on the blue side. Maybe just mixing this with the palette knife that I got. And then at the start you're just kind of doing a basic, well that's a high one, indentation of the mountain kind of shape that you want. You're only really worrying about the top when you do this. What I kind of love about creative kind of things like this, because I've done a lot of music in the past and now I'm kind of more into painting, that's kind of like my focus, is that it's really beautiful to kind of create these things and develop a skill, and you kind of realize that you know, part of you that maybe you're not really aware of, or that's kind of deep, kind of inside of yourself, kind of comes out in this, you know? It's not the, like this, creating is not like this logical kind of process. It's something that kind of happens, and you can't really force it, and you kind of have to go with it. And it's kind of nice, I think, that you learn a bit more about yourself. And it's fun to kind of create these kind of things and express yourself. I'm just kind of bringing this paint down, thinning it down so that it's easy to put another paint on top of it. I'm just roughly following like the contours of the mountain. It also creates some mist at the base. And I already really love that, like just the look of that, just like the outline of the mountains and then the you know, the mist that comes down. I'll get it like this. So now I'm going to do the snow on it. And this is something that I had a lot of trouble with, you know. I feel like the kind of shape of my mountains were coming out okay. Pretty well. I was kind of happy with it, but I had really a lot of trouble with the Bob Ross style doing a putting the snow on it and making it break and making it kind of look sort of semi-realistic. And if you are kind of worried about that, I'll kind of show you what I've done, what I learnt, because I used to just kind of smear it on, you know, like whether it was just even like that, and you don't really want it like that. You want to first pull this kind of flat so then it's kind of even. And then I wipe it off and you just get a, well that's a shit roll, sorry, swearing. Just want to get like a roll at like kind of the end of it. And I would come in from this side and kind of come across. And that would just leave this straight line, and I was kind of like, why isn't it kind of looking like, how am I going to get like all the different lines rather than just like this straight one down? And that's because you're actually supposed to come down from this side, like this, and just kind of let it break. And I probably had a bit too much in there, which is why there's like a bit of a snow cap on there. But you gotta hold this really lightly as well. I was like doing it like this and just putting it on. And you don't really get the breaks like that when you do it like that. So I'll just kind of go along. And it's also a lot easier to do this from this side if you're right-handed, because doing it like that is kind of awkward. You have to twist your arm a bit. But also, I'll show you when I do the shadow, is that you've got to come from this side as well. And I was coming from this side, but you've got to have it coming from a different angle, because you've got to think of the sun's hitting this side, so this side's in the shadow and it's like opposing it rather than just kind of floating down. just wipe off some of the paint that I pick up when I do this. That probably too much paint. Oh well, we'll leave it in alone. Just gonna grab, put some. And then you create this contrast between all of your kind of layers. And then you can even like add some something there. And then there's like another little vibe that's like sitting there. And this one looks a bit straight, so I'm gonna do something similar to that. Yeah. And I think the most important thing about this method is that you kind of course you kind of understand like why and how these things kind of work, but just gaining experience in anything, whatever it is, and just practicing, and then kind of working on your mistakes and kind of asking myself, like, why did it turn out like this? Like, why isn't it turning out how I kind of want it to? And then you kind of, and then I go back and kind of watch some of his tutorials again, and then I see, oh, I was doing that, and he kind of does this. And then you pick up all these different skills, and then you learn a bit more, and yeah, it's kind of like this ongoing process. I just accidentally added some red into that instead of blue, but that should be alright. And you see you come from this side. And the shadows are a bit harder to do because you kind of have to see, get into all like these nooks and crannies and, you know, not try and stuff up the ones that you've already done. That's probably a bit red. See, I just realised I was holding onto it like this, and it wasn't really breaking as well as I thought it was. I'll do a bit more here. You see, those mountains turned out alright. I kind of stuffed up that part, it looked good. And you know, that red that I have in the shadow, it's not ideal, I probably should have had blue. I can actually put red into that, so oopsie. I'm gonna do another one just to kind of show you again. And I'll darken it up like I said before, because as you get closer it gets a bit darker. Yeah, that'll be good. Oh actually I should miss this out. Create a separation and it kind of gives it more distance. Now we already have that kind of mist down there. It's just a bit of this kind of mountain range helps. Oh, why did I do that? Sorry about the noise. I don't know what's going on over there, but yeah. basically I'm doing the same thing. I've just left that gap there to kind of, you know, create a bit of distance. And you see how these white bits here that don't kind of look that good? I probably should have put this mountain back a little bit more. But now that I have it like that, I could just put trees up into those little gaps there, kind of cover it up, because as Bob Ross says, we don't make mistakes, we have happy accidents. What a lovely fellow as well Bob Ross is, you know, and even Bill Alexander. They're such positive, you know, happy kind of people. And for so long, you know, I always thought that, you know, life kind of sucked and like bad things were just happening to me and that's kind of how life is. But you realise that you can actually be happier, you can actually like enjoy these sorts of things in that. I'm just going to get some clean white because I don't have any. Kind of use too much of that red. Then again, I'm just pulling it really flat. Wipe that off. Grab some on. Wipe that up in there. Again, I kind of put too much on so it kind of looks like I'm more like icing a cake or something. I need to pull it down a bit more harder, I think, so when it's thinner, and I just get a thin roll of paint. Yep, that's what he says, a thin roll of paint. Still, I guess these mountains are just going to be a bit more icier. They're a bit cooler. Sometimes they go their way, your way, sometimes they don't. Those ones look alright. Now, I'm going to add blue this time, not red, to that colour. Just to darken it down a tiny bit. Another important thing is kind of mixing like the right colours. Again, I've not pulled that flat enough. I'm just kind of rushing it a bit if I'm honest, because I don't want to take too long with this video. Right, there we go, there's the mountain number two. Now I'm gonna just quickly put that down. They're actually out of brown. I'm gonna do some trees up in there and there, where I said before. So we'll just add it with the white. Let's
a bit too much.
Just trying to get it to kind of even. Show you how I fix that. Some of that into that green and that mountain color, and I turn that into a big bush. A big bushy tree.
Boom.
No mistakes. Now I've just kind of filled in those gaps where it kind of looks odd. I'm just gonna put some grass there. And some over this side as well. I'm going to that green, make a lot of green. Because a thin paint will stick onto a thick paint. Shrubs down there. Usually I go into like some more yellow and kind of have a bit more. Different colours in the bushes. Some bushes in there, little tree trunks or sticks or whatever. Then grab that lifted light again. Make a shoreline there. Gotta sign that now. Definitely not one of my best paintings, but you know, not everyone goes your way. And kind of what I wanted to showcase was a few things that I'd learnt from the mountain, and kind of talk a bit about creativity and, you know, how beautiful it can kind of be to create art like this. There's a signature. that's the painting done, so thank you for watching if you did. You know, I'm going to keep doing this weekly, kind of show my progress, the things that I've learnt, kind of talk a bit about it, and see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.